For more on the floods in Pakistan, I talked a short time ago to that country's foreign minister, Shah Mahmood Qureshi. Minister Qureshi, thank you very much for talking with us.
You're welcome.
What is the latest you can tell us on the scale of this disaster and what your country is doing to deal with it?
Well, the scale is huge, as you've learned, that over 20 million people have been affected. Millions have been displaced. Over a million houses are damaged. You know, physical infrastructure like roads, bridges, have been sort of battered very badly by this unprecedented flood that we've had. Issues of waterborne disease are sort of a big challenge that we are confronting with. I was here in New York to address the special session of the General Assembly, highlighting these issues and drawing world attention to this evolving situation, this unprecedented flood situation that we in Pakistan are dealing with. We mobilized all our national resources, but we need international help, and we need it now.
And how much of that help is coming?
Well, I would say the initial response was slow because the world was not aware of the magnitude of the challenge. But now I think it is filtering in, it is pouring in. The UN appeal launched the other day on the 11th of August of $460 million. I think from the response that I saw yesterday and today, I think that target will be met. But that's only the beginning. We have to look at the recovery and the rehabilitation and reconstruction costs as well.
We heard last night on the program from U.S. Special Representative Richard Holbrooke. He told my colleague Jim Lehrer that ultimately the costs are going to run in the billions. He did express concern about aid coming in from other nations. Are you now satisfied that that aid is starting to come in as you need it?
Well, I think I'm satisfied to the extent that today I think I have been able to sensitize the world leaders who were present here yesterday and their representatives and senior officials who were at the GA session that this is a very serious, indeed a very alarming, critical situation. To that extent, we have succeeded. But now, to what extent the world responds, we'll have to wait and see.
One of the things Ambassador Holbrooke said last night was that China, as of yesterday, it was not clear how much China was prepared to do. Now we know two planes, I understand, have arrived in Punjab from the Chinese. Do you expect more?
Well, China has been giving us relief goods. They have provided us financial assistance as well. I believe they're announcing some more today. They have also taken responsibility of some population up in the north, Gilgit, Baltistan area, that had become inaccessible because of the loss of bridges on the way. So there was no road connection left with that area, and the only way you could access them was through the Chinese border. And they've taken responsibility for about 27,000 people in that area.
The $5 million in aid you're now getting from India, it took some time to work this out. What's the significance of that?
Well, we have been helping each other in the past. India has helped Pakistan during the 2005 earthquake. We responded to them when they had natural disasters. So there is a precedent, and we are neighbors. So this was a very welcome gesture on their part, and we in Pakistan appreciate this gesture.
And political sensitivity to accepting that money from India?
No, as I said, there are past precedents, they've helped us, and we've helped them.
We've also talked this week, Mr. Foreign Minister, about, on this program, we've discussed whether your government is capable of dealing with a disaster of this magnitude. How do you answer that question?
I would say any government would find this disaster challenging. Any government, whether it's a first world government or a third world government, it is huge. And you have to understand that. So that is why, despite all our resources, national resources, provincial resources, we will need international help.
And to those, because there has been discussion about some extremist groups operating in Pakistan, to anyone on the outside who, for a political reason, may be hesitant to make a contribution, what do you say?
I think the overwhelming majority of the people of Pakistan are against those militant groups. They have been cornered. We've been fighting them. We've had successful operations against them. We are a major ally of the United States and the free world in defeating extremism and terrorism. And we've paid a price, a human price, economic price. I think the world should stand by its ally in this hour of need.
And to sum this up, Mr. Foreign Minister, how would you characterize the most urgent needs of your people right now?
Well, the most urgent need today is relief. We have to provide them with food. We have to provide them with shelter. We have to provide them with medicines that protect them against waterborne disease. We have to cater to their rehabilitation, early recovery, you know, provide them assistance to return home and rebuild their homes, provide them to start their livelihoods again, you know, agriculture. Most of the agriculture area has been, the bread basket has been hit very severely. So we'll have to provide them with seed and fertilizer so that they can plant their coming winter crop.
And just from a personal perspective, Mr. Minister, what does this mean to you?
Well, it's a shaking. It has shaken me, like many, many Pakistanis and many citizens all across the world, to see this natural disaster.
All right, we are going to leave it there. Foreign Minister Makhdoom Shah Mahmood Qureshi, thank you very much.
Thank you.